Here's the contract I drafted, and I promise I will fulfill all the terms listed in there. I said to my mom, I will do whatever it took in order to get a better education. Although I was already enrolled in a top international school in Shanghai, I knew in order to truly get a better education, I had to go back to America. Most of you probably don't know that I came to RG in 8th grade, but I went back to Shanghai for 9th, and then came back to prep for another 9th grade. 4 years of back and forth, from Shanghai to LA and LA to Shanghai. My constantly changing schools in two countries had already worn my parents out. Therefore, this time, they refused to let me move again. My parents had taken time out of their busy schedule to help me apply to the best schools in Taiwan and Shanghai, and thought I was taking things for granted. Even though I had completed the application to RHP by myself, my mom still resisted. Several weeks after I applied, I received my admission to RHP and student visa, which was mailed all the way from San Pedro to Shanghai. However, while I was so excited that I could finally go back to America to study, my mom came to me, trying to take away my student visa and tear it apart. I ran back to my room and hid my I-20, the only form that would allow me to enter and study in the United States. Then, a cold war began between my parents and me. For 2 weeks, we treated each other like strangers. I avoided eye contact with them and refused to stay in the same room as them. They were mad at me for taking things for granted and being impulsive in decision making. And I was mad at them for not letting me change school again and not respecting my decision. By the middle of August, I realized that the cold war must end and that I must do something to persuade them. Otherwise, I could only stay in Shanghai. So I went to my mom and talked to her about the pros and cons of studying in America. And I promised her that I would cherish this opportunity and work hard in school. After many talks, she still hesitated. I even drafted a contract, listing out all the things I promised I would accomplish, such as getting straight A's, promising that this would be the last time I'm changing school. And I even wrote on the contract, if I don't fulfill all the terms, my mom has the right to take me back to Shanghai even without my agreement. So she finally agreed. As you all can tell by now, for me, coming to the US was not easy, but I did not give up even under my parents' pressure. I was clear in what I wanted and was determined to lead my own future. Of course, today my parents no longer need the contract with me because the attainment of my goals has proved that I had enough maturity. I fulfilled everything I promised I would, and I'm constantly working to improve myself through activities, internships, and summer programs. I guess what I want to say is that never give up in what you want, but give your best effort in achieving your goals, and once you attain them, cherish them and make the best out of them. Shout out, Mr. Brahma. I'm so lucky to have you as my senior year advisor. Mr. Holloway, I don't know why I see you everywhere on campus, but thank you for pushing me so hard last year in AP Lit and helping me to become a better writer. Ms. Diamond, the college application process was really stressful and confusing, but it was so much easier with your help and support. Sorry. Mr. McCormick, thank you for always encouraging me and checking on me regularly to make sure that I don't stress out, and it is very heartwarming for me. Ms. Carr, I really enjoyed taking your classes for 2 years despite the amount of homework you gave us. Thank you for always being so patient with us and dealing with our craziness in class. Ms. Hagee, thank you for being so caring for me and giving me a hug when I need it. It really means a lot. And I'll definitely buy your Starbucks next time I go. Rio, sorry for being mean to you, but I just can't help it. V, Vera, you're just as crazy as I am, and that's why we always have endless topics to talk and laugh about. But I hope you can distract me less in math class and stop being so attached to your Canadian boyfriend 24/7. Kelly, we've known each other for almost 6 years. We've had our ups and downs, and we used to fought a lot. I'm so glad we finally became close friends. Thank you for understanding me and being there for me whenever I need you. And I know that I never say so, but I love you so much. I'm so grateful to have a friend like you. Scott, thank you for being such a supportive friend, and it is very reassuring to know that you will always have my back and are always willing to listen to me no matter what happens. Mom and Dad, I know how hard it was when you guys first started your businesses, but I also know how hard it was for you guys to decide to give up everything you had in China just to come and stay with me in America. I truly appreciate everything you guys have done for me, and without your love and support, I would not be as successful as I am today. I know that I rarely say so, but I love you guys so much, and I'm so lucky to have you guys